The whole thing starts in St. Catherine's Primary School in Cramling in Northumberland, where I was a school teacher.
No, it doesn't. It starts off at St. Albans City and, Hall, where I was playing with Curve Dare.
And anyway, let me move on to Stuart and I meeting, and me discovering Stuart in some hippie group, the Curved Airs, and then we form the Police.
It all ends up with Sting wearing a silly hat.
And the script will be our interviews. It's called, I Wanna Be, it's next to you!
Jet lag after a 19-hour journey from London. We are here in Tokyo at the Shibuya Kokaido Hall, which I think is a reasonable pronunciation. Police are playing, and already you can sense that various numbers are pretty well known.
How do you feel, Japanese culture? I'm really enjoying it, but it's not Japanese enough for me at the moment. In Tokyo, it's very Americanized, and it's a little bit of a shock. Well, not a shock, really. I suppose it's to be expected. But I'm looking forward to getting out of Tokyo to see a bit more of Japanese life.
Bring on the night. It's already here.
Tomorrow is just another day.
incredibly organized. They will meet the police. If they're arriving by train, they will be at the station. They have the taxi ready to follow the van to its hotel. They have rooms booked in the hotel, and they stay. They come to the concert there at the hotel afterwards.
I'm gonna grab those. Yeah, that brown one. The brown one.
I've got all their names and numbers. I'm having them shipped home. Little porcelain dolls.
We've come today from Nagoya, back on the bullet train, on our way to Osaka. And although we're traveling south, it's getting colder and the mountains are covered in snow, which is something I didn't expect, and nor did anybody else. Summers is a reincarnation of Harpo Marx. He even juggles with oranges quite well, actually.
Strike the Tokyo set, thank you.
And he's very much the natural comedian. Serving his energy, because the moment they go on stage, wow, he's there, and he's very much a dynamic front man. But then I wouldn't actually say that, because the police is three front men, which is one of the reasons they're so good.
I'm writing a song.
Oh, well.
Ichisubi. You don't have to put out the Green Lantern.
Yeah. Okay, well, thank you. When did you first start organizing this?
About 3 months ago.
4 months ago?
3 months ago.
Japan is a fairly conventional place to play because the police have had hits here. So the other places that they're going to are places that nobody's ever been to.
It's very rare. Hong Kong, they have them every few, well, 3, 4 months, 5 months. No, you don't hear much about it, but they do have them. Cairo, Bombay, places like that, never hedge. Well, Cairo had the Grateful Dead play at the Pyramids, and that's the closest they got. Bombay or India has never had a rock show at all.
Yes, here we have a Ming Dynasty cheesecake. You'll notice the chocolate flavoring on the roof there, graduating to a more sherbet flavor on the little girl. Love can mend your life, but love can break your heart. Come on, I give you an autograph, so you can give me an autograph.
In a bottle. Oh, I smell? Oh, really?
Are you police dog?
Yes, I am.
He is police dog.
I'll send an SOS to the world. I'll send an SOS to the world. I hope that's
having a lovely time.
How far have you come to see the police?
14th.
Since the 14th?
Yes. Tokyo.
You've been following them since Tokyo?
Yes.
What, staying but, in the same hotel?
Yes, same hotel.
Yeah? How did you find out where they were going to stay?
My friend told me.
Yeah?
Told me, yes.
How did she find out?
I don't know.
You know?
Ecstasy. Noodles in Kyoto. What a way to make a living.
Up, not drop it down. You're supposed to be taken from above. And with great slurping noises of contentment.
Contentment.
Well, it must have cost you a fortune. It must have cost you a lot of money.
Yes.
And where did you get the money from?
My parents gave me.
Yeah?
Yes.
Did they give you the money knowing what you would spend it on?
No.
Ah, what did they think? What did they think you spent the money on?
Tour with my friend, just a sightseeing tour.
Oh, sightseeing tour.
Yes.
I see.
Walking on the moon. Will go. I just bought half the shop. I'm having the whole shop wrapped up and sent back to London for me. See, the shops come really small here.
That's too fast.
No, it's not. It can never be too fast.
It's better fast. It really feels better when it's faster.
I mean, it can be too fast. I miss this. I'm wishing my day.
reggae influences?
Yes.
How long has the group been formed? Do you find it easy, now that success has come to you, do you find that it has changed your life in any way?
I can't really understand.
Where did you first meet?
You?
Mm-hmm.
Tokyo.
I see. Cut.
Andy. Where are we? Hong Kong.
Wonderful.
Hey, baby. So they finally threw you off the reservation, eh?
Yeah, it's good, isn't it?
Magic.
Man, hey, you play everything. Twice the
time
of
my life.
All of my life.
But.
He's lovely, actually. He lives up to his latest record.
Sorry, man. You're panic stricken every time you play. Because I think you play like a.
The winner of the best album of 1979 is Regatta de Blanc by The Police.
Yay!
Well, ladies and gentlemen, the Police are unable to be here this evening, as they say, because they are, in fact, currently on a tour of the Far East.
Sludge.
Not at all.
You're not well, my love.
So, Radio 1 DJ Anne Nightingale has flown out to Hong Kong with their trophy. So let's now go to Hong Kong from the Café Royal over to Anne Nightingale.
Excuse me, person in your dressing room. But this is the moment. I've come 6,000 miles. Police. You've just come off stage.
Oh, great. Best album.
I'd like to present you with From London.
Do what?
British Rock and Pop Awards 1979 for the best album called Stuart, Your Pronunciation is the Best.
Regatta de Blanc.
Congratulations.
Oh, is this our life?
Thank you.
Where's Amy
it
Andrews?
Is. He's, did you think when you made this album that you would actually be presented with an award in Hong Kong?
So yes. It's going on my wall.
Thank you! I feel so! I feel so! I feel so!
Fat Li Wong Do Hu Ching Wong Hang. Fung Ching Hong Ling Chong Funi Hojimoto.
Stuart, you're using the passive tense.
No one's knocks upon my door. For a thousand years or more. All just up and over.
樂隊嘅成員啦。咁啊，剛才即係同大家講嘅嘢啦，大家聽到佢哋三位咧都係有好迷人嘅磁性嘅男性魅力嘅聲音。咁而家我開始咧就係問我哋今日嘅訪問裡面嘅第一個問題，我想知道一下三位可唔可以自我介紹一下自己 ？Could you give us a brief introduction of yourself？
Give us 10 minutes to rest. Hong, Ling, Tong, Hung, Ching, Ham, wonton soup, please.
Nah, 唔好玩啊，講真一句， let's be serious. Andy, can you briefly introduce yourself to our audience?
Hello, I'm Andy. I play guitar in the band.
Andy 咧一本正經咁話，佢就係 Andy 啦。咁佢咧就係負責樂隊裡面嘅吉他部分嘅。What about you, Stuart?
My name is Stuart. How do you do? And I play drums in the group.
呢一位咧就係 Police 樂隊裡面嘅鼓手啦。咁而喺我隔離咧攞張膠紙黐住個口，唔知係咪唔想講嘢嘅咧，就係 Sting。Sting 咧就係樂隊裡面嘅靈魂嚟噶。So what about you, Sting?
I am do what's left. I sing and play the bass.
Take me dress off now, I've had enough.
Okay, well, let's put the group roll in this one, okay?
Wait.
Put the road crew in this one and this one, and the film crew can go in the end.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
Well, I think that's it. The group have arrived. We're here in Bombay.
Owned a dairy.
Yeah, eventually.
You told me he was a milkman.
He is a milkman. Oh, it sounds very grand. It's you know, two vans. And about, I forget how many gallons he delivers every day, but he still, you know, goes out and he's done so for the past 30 years.
Do.
No, I hadn't a clue. There's no work in Newcastle. So nobody had a plan except the sign on the dole, maybe. So I didn't know at all what to do. And I went through the mill of, you know, just carried on my education as far as possible until I got sick of it. And I worked on building sites and got a job in the civil service. And then I decided to become a teacher, largely through just lack of imagination. But I thought it would give me time to decide what I really wanted to do.
Time and Talents Victory Stall, where they've done all the bookings for the tickets and everything. We're now about to meet the ladies in the Time and Talents Club.
I'd always played the guitar and stuff, because there was always a guitar around and I could always knock out a tune and entertain the relatives when they came.
Since you were what, that big?
Yeah.
What made you start playing bass if you'd grown up playing guitar?
I like the sound of the bass, double bass or bass guitar. It's a very powerful instrument, but it's very subtle.
Yes, I think the ladies will introduce themselves to you. I think it'll be much easier
we
that
go
way.
Outside.
Yeah. Who is Sting?
I'm Sting.
You know, the whole syndrome of lead guitar heroes never really appealed to me. I was never into that.
You can see we've got, you know, the best possible people to organize our situation in India. I think we're...
Hello.
Hello. Hi. When I listened to records as a kid, I used to turn the bass up on the record player, and actually to hear the bass line better, I would play it 78. I was much more interested in bass than treble. That's just the way my ears are, I suppose. That's what I prefer.
Well, the Time and Talents Club has been in existence for the last 46 years, and we are a band of ladies, all working entirely for charities, giving our time, energy, talents, and we have...
When I borrowed my first bass guitar, it was the Blues Boom, and I was about 13.
I was wondering if you were influenced by the music of that time.
Yeah, I mean, you know, there was John Mayall and the Blues Breakers, Eric Clapton and Cream and Jimi Hendrix.
But this is the first time, the very first time, when we are involved in presenting, I'm very proud to say, one of the world's greatest, or maybe the greatest pop rock group. And that
immediately before punk happened in London, I was into people like Chick Corea, Miles Davis, Herbie Hancock. I kind of American techno flash.
But you were playing jazz?
After that, yeah. After that period, I just totally lost interest in rock music. I never liked Led Zeppelin or Deep Purple or any of those heavy groups. I became more interested in jazz, more interested in what I considered serious music. And I suppose if you wanted a title for what I was at the time, I was an aspiring muso. And I wanted to be taken seriously as a musician.
This is called I Can't Stand Losing You.
Something known as a in-store appearance, a promotional device whereby the group shows up in the records and signs autographs records for the record buyers. Usually it means the record store gets mobbed and lots of kids get their records signed. They buy lots of records because the group's there and everything. Well, this is one that takes place in Bombay in India. So we're up to date on the current musical scene in India, or Bombay at least.
Do you know Cairo really well?
Well, no, I don't really remember it all that well because I only came back here to visit it when I was living in Lebanon, which I lived in for 10 years and which I do remember really well.
But I mean, your actual childhood was in the Middle East because of your father's activities.
That's right. He was diplomatic. And I don't wish to go into any further detail.
Well, I think you already have. There's so many other people. Well, I think you should tell us about your father.
It's pretty well exposed that he was a CIA agent, except that I didn't know about it at the time. I was just a kid. In fact, I didn't find out about it until I was in college in California, and he wrote his book, and it was printed on the liner notes. Roxanne!
I've just smoked this one.
Wasn't it my Boston?
He just smoked your camel.
Well, I think we should just get off, you know? Let's go.
Let's go. Yeah.
Caravan. You don't have to wear that dress tonight. Walk the streets for money. You don't care if it's wrong or if it's right.
What actually happened to Curve Dare? Why, in the end?
Well, let's see. It was a band that was contaminated by the music industry. The two albums I did were both rejected by the record company. And when you've spent £20,000 on recording an album, only to have it rejected by a guy wearing a business suit who doesn't know anything about music because it sounds too rough-shod or because it's too quirky, well, basically because you can't get it on the radio, then it makes you very paranoid when you're writing music and working in the studio. Your record that you make has to be something that they can play on the radio. And there's no room for taking any chance for doing anything really artistic. It's entirely commercial game. You don't have
to put on the red light. I'm gonna show these. Where is that? Cairo, Rommel, the desert.
Second pyramid. They were all covered in alabaster originally, but the people came and built their houses out of them, which is why they're a little bit smaller than they originally were. But that one with a top on it is the original covering, alabaster, which all of them were covered in. Fascinating, huh? Bit disappointed, I suppose, that it wasn't as romantic and artistic as I thought it was going to be. But then again, I never really thought it would be because I'd been working in the business for all that time.
So what happened then?
The punk revolution happened then, and suddenly it became actually possible to form a group and make music that had never had any hope at all of getting on the radio.
And did you think the name up, Police?
Oh yeah.
Was that before you found the what ended up being who ended up being in the band?
Yeah. In fact, the whole thing was pretty much planned out before I even found the people.
So it was really your instigation, the whole thing?
Well, it started out that way, but of course what's happened since then is pretty much a three-way effort.
When you really want to get down to it, Sting loves to dress up, you know what I mean? Get in all these funny costumes. I mean, every place we've been, he's got into the local costumes. And here he is again. Gets to do a little bit of stripping, you know? There's our boy.
I got good news and bad news.
Yes.
The bad news first. Yes. Nothing but sand.
And the good news?
Plenty of it. Ah.
What about discipline within the band?
Discipline? Oh, yes, I like to discipline both of the other guys as much as I possibly can. I tie them up, smack their bottoms. Yes.
Loads of things. Musical discipline.
Oh, that, yeah. I don't know, we're a peculiar sort of mixture of discipline and absolute lethargy. It's funny, really. We started off at the beginning of our career rehearsing and rehearsing a lot because we couldn't get any gigs. And then...
What, for something to do?
Yeah, really. When the dam sort of finally broke, we started to have some success. Rehearsals just went out the window altogether. We hadn't rehearsed for over a year. The only rehearsals of any sort we ever get are at sound checks. I mean, the way it started is that, I mean, you know, reggae is very prevalent in London, and there's so much of it. But we were all listening to it on our own, I think, and when we were rehearsing, we started jamming on reggae together.
I guess it felt like, you know, potting a few balls.
Eventually, we applied it to a couple of songs, So Lonely and Roxanne. Those were the first songs we tried with any sort of approach like that. And we used it to our own ends. We didn't just try to copy reggae and play one token reggae song. We really enjoyed playing it. So for us, it was a sort of a jamming medium. And then we fused it with a rock, and then it sort of became our own thing.
I say it's nice to be here in Athens. What do you call the place? Athena or something? I lost me thing. This is a song called Driven to Tears. Look out!
gig, or the first British gig that anyone's played in Greece since 1967.
I thought it was amazing. I mean, obviously, not having had a rock group for 13 years, whatever it is here, they've been building up for a long time. You know, I think that was very apparent last night. I mean, there was that huge mob of people. I think there were 5,000 people outside who couldn't get in, and the crowd inside, and the fact that we are doing very well here, apparently, as well. I mean, those two things combined together, it was just a very overwhelming and an emotional concert last night, I thought.
3, 4, 5, 6!
Living was never like this. We took all those GCs.